One for the good guys!
Darling.
Try and
Victory will be ours!
We win again.
Is ours.
Little
oops.
Giant Darkness!
Easy.
All is well that ends well.
Thank you.
Take this!
I'm on fire! Here we go.
Oh, Aerie. Thanks. Ah! Try this for some.
Pizza!
Who else wants some? Another one bites the dust.
Things are looking up.
Easy. Thank you.
finally.
We have carried the day.
things. I'm ready for anything.
Something is not right here. Be on your guard. Behind me!
since time beyond memory. I have been sealed away in that frozen fjord. But now I am released. Alas, my lengthy imprisonment has sorely depleted my powers. If the skies above Sniffleheim are to once more dance with fire, then first I must feast. You shall have the honor of being the Auroral Serpent's Sabbath.
Don't let your guard down.
Leave it to me!
Not done yet!
Are you all right, honey?
Here, princess! I'm not done yet!
Pick me up?
Take it!
Ago. But where Alduin succeeded, you shall succumb!
What the... can't... move!
Piteous wretches, prepare to be consumed!
Don't worry, everyone. I'll have you back on your feet in no time.
Who are...
No way!
Bold luminary, Yggdrasil's chosen, long have I waited to greet you. We of Arborea swear to protect you. While we live, none shall defeat you. It's ever so nice to see you all again.
Serena, it's really you. Thanks for helping us out there. Where did you spring from, and where have you been?
I've been trying to make my way back to Arborea ever since that awful day. But I got rather sidetracked seeing to those who needed my help. When I heard that the golden iceberg blocking Sniffelheim Harbor had melted away, I decided to try and make my way home from there. I never thought I'd meet you on the way.
You're heading to Arborea, eh? We're on our way there ourselves. Reckoned you keepers would be the best folk to ask about a certain sacred flying contraption.
A flying contraption? Well, I've never heard of such a thing, but I'm sure Father Benedictus will know something about it. It's so wonderful to see you all again. Would you mind awfully if I tagged along with you? If we follow the path up the mountain, we'll be in Arborea in no time. Well then, shall we?
Not done yet!
May heaven's wind propel thee hence!
Another day, another victory.
Easy. So beautiful here before.
Our poor little angels. Veronica, Serena, please come back. We'll do anything.
Fidelis. Alma, you must not lose hope. Veronica and Serena are the heirs to the power of that most holy of sages. As long as they are together, there is nothing that can...
Oh. Serena? Is it really you? Mother? Father? You're alive!
Oh, Serena, my little angel. I never thought I'd see you again.
Serena, my child, have you come back to us alone? What of Veronica?
She's not here. But I thought she must have made her way home already. She's certainly somewhere nearby. I can sense it. Somewhere north of here.
You can really tell where she is?
Yes, it's her. I know it is. We have to go and find her.
You think Veronica's really here? If she is, she's keeping a low profile.
When we were children, Veronica and I would often come to this grove to play. I was sure she would be waiting for me here. Veronica! Veronica, where are you? Ah, there she is! I knew it! Wake up, lazy bones! You'll catch cold sleeping outside like this. Veronica? Look, her staff is shining. And so is the mark on your hand. Do you think if you touch it, you might have one of your visions? This If Yggdrasil falls, the world will... to the luminary. Veronica. You gave your life to save us.
No! Darling, even in your final moments, you were thinking of your friends.
No!
Oh, Veronica.
Why must the good die young?
Isn't here after all. She's gone. But I will not let her death be in vain. Where she led, I must follow. I have to tell everyone. I have to tell Mother and Father.
Great and glorious Yggdrasil, whose holy heart is the symbol of all life. Today, we mourn the loss of a beloved child of Arborea. Though she came into life with another of your hallowed leaves, she departed this realm alone. May she one day return to you and bloom again upon your branches.
I thank you all for gathering here today to celebrate the life of my dear sister. Even in her darkest hour, Veronica thought not of herself, but only of protecting the luminary. She was a keeper to the last. Now, I ask that each of you offer up a lock of hair to the sacred flame, that its light may guide her on her way back to the World Tree.
Oh, Veronica, my little angel. Curse you, Mordigan. Why could you not have taken me instead?
My darling, darling daughter. How could you leave us without saying goodbye?
Serena appears steadfast despite her grief. But the sight of her poor parents is heartbreaking indeed.
My child, I must speak with you and your friends. When you have a moment, please come to the cathedral. Forgive me for summoning you here at this time of sadness, but there is something I believe you will be eager to hear. You came in search of the sacred conveyance upon which Erdwin and his allies rode out to face the Dark One, did you not?
How did you know that?
Well, some days before your arrival, Holy Yggdrasil granted me another vision. I saw you, honored luminary. You were standing alongside Serena upon a great white object that transported you to an island in the sky. A strange and beautiful place.
And you think this was a vision of the future?
I do, for in my dream, Veronica was not with you. I have been greatly troubled as to what her absence might mean. I had hoped and prayed that my fears were unfounded, yet, alas, they were not. which made me wonder if the conveyance upon which you stood might also be real. And then I remembered. Cetacea. The legends tell of a divine being who soared through the skies on silver wings, a beast summoned to Erdwin's side by a mystical melody. Perhaps it was upon Cetacea's back that you rode in my vision. And perhaps the island upon which you alighted is the next step on your journey. I intend to scour the annals for indications of how she might be summoned. I will inform you forthwith if my researches should prove fruitful. Now, the day's unhappy events have surely taken their toll. Rooms have been prepared for you all at the inn. Pray, rest a while.
It's a love song from the Age of Heroes, the story of a lady pining for her long-lost sweetheart. No one remembers who wrote it, but I've loved it since I was a little girl. You know, something's been bothering me. Veronica? We were born at the same time, so our leaves bloomed at the same time, didn't they? Do you think they'll fall at the same time too?
I don't know. You've always been a bit slow, to be honest. But I hope they do. Serena, I want you to promise me something. If anything happens to me, promise you'll finish this without me.
I shan't promise anything of the sort. I don't even want to think of such things. If only I had promised to do as she asked. Perhaps she might have been able to make her sacrifice more easily. She was right, you know. I always have been slow. When it came to talking or walking or learning magic, I was always a step behind her. But now I must tread my own path. Alone. I hate to ask, but would you mind awfully not going anywhere for a little while? I think I'm going to cry. Thank you. I'm sorry to be such a bother, but I shan't be one any longer. Veronica died to save me. I must make the most of my life, for her sake. No more tears. That was the old me. Goodbye. What in the world? I feel different. Thank you, dear sister. Should I say good afternoon? The sun's already high in the sky. Father Benedictus dropped by earlier. He says he has something to show us at the top of the mountain. Everyone else has gone on ahead, but I thought I'd wait for you.
Shall we go and join them? There's a little door to the right of the cathedral. The path is through there.
There you are. So glad you could finally join us. Yggdrasil blessed me with another vision in the night. I saw Veronica standing upon this very ledge. It is known as Luminary's Landing, when Erdwin descended from the heavens after facing the Dark One. This is where he alighted. And this is the Calamus flute. In my dream, Veronica played upon it. It once belonged to the great sage Serenica. She left it in Arborea on her final visit, the day after the Dark One finally fell. I gave it to Veronica as a memento of her heroic ancestor. And yet, when I awoke this morning, there it was, upon my pillow. It is a sign. The flute will reveal the path you must tread. Serena, my child, if you would be so kind.
Of course. I think I must be doing it wrong. But if Veronica was playing it in Father Benedictus's vision, it must be the key. Can you try, perhaps? The mark! It's glowing!
What the?
A fishing rod? I fear it is I who am seeing visions.
You got a bite! Oh, go on, darling! Reel it in!
As I suspected. It was upon her back that you rode in my dream. The sacred conveyance of the luminary, Cetacea. It seems that she heeds the call of the flute. You must play it whenever you require her aid. Go, Luminary, and seek out the floating island. It is the World Tree's will. Whatever awaits you there will surely aid you in the fight against the Lord of Shadows. Do not let Veronica's sacrifice be in vain. Now, play.
Things are looking up. We win again.
This'll see you right. Great host.
You won't get away with this!
Here goes nothing!
My thanks. My thanks.
Try and dodge it!
We'll soon have that patched up.
Princess!
Don't worry, I'm here to help.
Another one bites the dust. Who else wants some?
Thanks.
Bad at all.
Oh no.
Almost feel bad about this.
Thank you.